In our title towards the main financial hub of Asia, Port City Colombo 2018 was held in Colombo yesterday. The event, which saw the participation of think tanks and academics, was organized by West End Law Center.
Now, this is an alteration to the Sri Lankan's geography, how I see it, the port city. You're building an artificial island is alteration to the boundary of Sri Lanka, the coastline. And how that will impact is about a discussion about geography and regulation. How I see the influence of Sri Lanka will face three spheres of influence, which is the US sphere of influence, Chinese sphere, and the Indian sphere of influence. And the geostrategic position of Sri Lanka is very important. So as you know, the Belt and Road Initiative, the $1 trillion initiative by an Asian nation, is actually connecting several continents, not only countries. And this can be a golden opportunity for Sri Lanka. Internal political stability is very important, because you won't bring your money, you won't invest if you don't have the internal political stability of a nation. Consistent policies are really, really important, from previous government to this government to the next government.
Are we permitted, or are we able to make these big investment decisions like Port City purely based on economics? And unfortunately, I would say we are not able to do that. We need to pay attention to strategic considerations of our neighbors and the other players in the environment or in the region. We cannot do anything to harm strategic interest of our big brother India. That is a fact. Geography is a variable, but it's a constant variable. We cannot change geography. We are so close to India. So in this situation, what would be the best option? I think if India and China can work together, that would be the best option for us. If India can invest alongside China, that would be the best option for us. Sri Lanka need not to benefit or hedge one against the other. That's the wrong way to go. We need to be the bridge between these two giants, between India and China. This, to me, is a national project. It is not a green project, it is not a blue project, it is not a red project, it is a national project.